Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition, Baldur's Gate 2. Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
If you say so, I want to go pick up Viconia right now. She's not necessarily going to be staying with us. Who's that? Well, Mourner.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Just we might need some help. Because we're going to try to do it's way down here somewhere. Right, the Fallen Paladins. Reynald de Chatillon promises to introduce me to Anorg if I can get a hold of a cup that belonged to Anorg as is still in possession of the Order. The cup is largely ceremonial but important to Anorg personally. Now, these people I heard are really rather tough over there, so a healer would be most welcome. Wherever the hell she might be. What? Stein? Was that? I saw a Stein show up. I swear I saw something that said Stein. There she is. Well, we're not looking for Stein, we're looking for Viconia, so. Oh, we got this fence here.
Jui, have you changed your mind?
I would like the opportunity to expend my debt to you, and I'm sure you will find a use for my mighty order of magics. Yes, I have, Viconia. Welcome. A judicious decision, wayfarers. Together we shall conquer your enemies without hesitation or mercy. I'm not sure what this has to do with anything, why we have to go out of our way to tell her this. We haven't to anybody else, but I can remember. One thing though, Viconia, you should probably know that Imuin is being held hostage by the cowled wizards and that I intend to rescue her. Maybe she don't like Imuin. I remember the insipidly cheerful girl you mentioned. He would risk such danger to recover her annoying presence. Why would you bother, Sapphire? I would no more abandon her to the cowled wizards than leave you to those fanatics, that's why. It seems that my own circumstance leaves me little choice. Very well, Sapphire. Let us rescue the girl if it means so much to your misguided senses.
I'm not worried. I'm sure these setbacks are only temporary.
Wow.
This behavior must not continue. Feel the burning stare of my hamster and change your ways.
Yeah. Squeak. What? A reputation is average, 11. I guess if she... Oh, if we keep bringing her into our party and let her go, we might lose reputation every time. That would not be good. Anyway, she is level 8 and we can level her up. We can choose another proficiency. Club, Flail, or Morning Star. Yeah, Flail or Morningstar, I guess. So the cleric-y type item. I missed what the other... Oh! Wow, we leveled up to 12. Sweet. And we have more spells we can memorize. Maybe not command so much. Doom is fine, might work. Bless. Remove fear. There's two of those. Hmm. Okay. Well, we will go that way. 4 Cure Light heals. Cure Light wounds, sorry. Doom. 2 Remove Fears, just in case. And a Bless. And then here we've got Find Traps. Get a Rogue for that. Flame Blade. I don't use that. Hold Person. I mean, maybe I'll have one of them memorized, not that many. Chant, I like. How about 2 chants then? Draw upon Holy Might. Sure. No alignment. Resist fire and cold. Silence, 15-foot radius. Slow poison. Just in case, we take out one chant and add another slow poison. Animate dead. Limited use. Yeah. Cure medium wounds. Dispel magic, all good. Glyph of warding. That's interesting, but I'm not sure if I'd ever use it. Cure disease. Sure, maybe one of that. Holy smite. Any evil creatures take 1d4 points of damage per level. So at this point, it would be 12 to 48 points of damage. Do I have that right? 12. Yeah, 48. Yeah. Alright. I like Holy Smite then. Where is it? I'll take out the Glyph of Warding. Invisibility Purge, very useful. Miscast Magic. Wow, she gets Miscast Magic early on. Protection Fire, Remove Curse, Remove Paralysis, Rigid Thinking, Strength of 1. Unholy Blight. Oh, it's for good creatures. Zone of Sweet Air. Alright, let me have Remove Paralysis. Cure Medium, well. Alright, let's get rid of Cure Disease. I have some potions for that. Cure Medium. Pretty much you need this stuff now and then. Level 4, we have Cure Serious, Lesser Restoration. Good, we're gonna need that. And Negative Plane Protection. Cloak of Fear. Free action. What's that? Holy Power. I have a lot of buff spells help with strength. Neutralize poison. Poison. Protection from evil. Alright, I'm gonna have to take out Negative Plane Protection. Put another one of those heals. Wow, she's got 6 level spells she can get to. Champion Strength. Creating a champion. Thaco bonus. In this case, it would be a Thaco bonus of 4. I guess I wouldn't cast it on Mintz because his strength would go down. Although it might still be an improvement because Thaco improving my 4. So damage rolls might be down a little. I would cast on someone like Yoshimo. Yeah. If it's above 18, it would automatically be reduced to this value. No. That's good, but she can't do anything else during that time. That's somewhat limiting. Flame Strike is pretty awesome. Magic Resistance. Raise Dead. Unfortunately, we're limited to 2. So I'm gonna do Cure Critical and... Was that... Is that Raise... No. This is Ray's dad. Bolt of Glory. By casting a spell, the priest channels a bolt of divine energy against the target. No attack roll is needed. Creatures struck suffer varying damage depending on their plane of origin. So, creatures that we're familiar with that come from this world, 66, elementals 3d4, undead is 8d6, and demons are 10d6. I like that one. False Dawn. Let's just put that for there for now. What's False Dawn? Calls into existence a bright reddish light as if sunrise were occurring within the area of effect. All undead creatures within a False Dawn suffer 66 points of damage. There is no saving throw. Affected undead also act confused on a round after the False Dawn appears. So it's like... This is an area of effect. Is that also area of effect? No, this is one creature. 8d6. So against one creature, if you're fighting one creature, it's better off to use this one anyway. Because you would harm one undead for a lot more than that. Get that off on a lich, that'll help. Alright, so I'm going to skip False Dawn. Heal. Disease and injury. Dispel feeble mind, mental disorders. Heals all points of damage. Okay. Physical mirror. Soul searing orb. Creates a glowing stone. A gem must be immediately thrown at the opponent. Make an attack roll, +3 bonus. Causes 66 points of fire damage and blinds the target for 1d6 rounds. Saving throw for half damage and no blindness. Undead creature. Nice. But I don't have room for it. Wondrous Recall. Bring back to memory 2 spells that have been previously cast. 5th level and under. Alright, well. That's gonna be that. Do we say anything?
Trust is for the foolish and the dead.
Yeah, I tried talking to them before and they wouldn't say much. Yeah. Nothing happens. Do I have to be selected, maybe?
What?
I got one of these left.
Fine.
Hmm. Yeah. But Viconia says something, though. She was. Alright, never mind then. She was saying something.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
No, well, she wasn't saying that. Where are we going? Okay, then. Okay. Off to the temple district.
Stand back for justice!
You got loud stuff. All this stuff. Alright, anyway, the... This is the area that we're looking for. It's not marked, but it is there. I'm hoping we can avoid bloodshed. We can just have Yoshimos steal the item. And have everyone be none the wiser. Just trying to clear the fog of war off. It didn't work, man. It didn't work. No hear ye. It's late. 5 a.m. Okay, it's early. Still too late and yet too early for hear ye, hear ye. Sarando. Oh, this is the one that someone was saying could be Cyrano de Bergerac.
Mm, yes.
My heart goes out to the Lady Erlana, but this is as close to a simple gnome such as I can ever hope to come to a noble beauty like her. Oh, yeah, don't sell yourself short. I'm sure you have some redeeming qualities. Just, I have no idea what they might be.
See, battle bow! Run, bow, run!
Now, we've already looked through here and grabbed some things. Sir Martis. Anyone in here? No, but this... Nor is there anything in here to see. Okay.
All the world.
I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
I doubt it's in here. We probably already looted this stuff. A buckler. Where might this cup be? Hmm. So we've talked to these people already. They might have something new to say. But I really don't want to alert them to, like... If there's anything new to say, it's going to be asking about that cup. And I don't want to give that away.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Not yet, anyway. Maybe here in that table.
All the world.
Fleet of foot and all that.
There was a prelate there. That's the stables. I doubt it would be hidden in there.
All the world is blind to my passing.
I forget time still passes. We're behind the guy.
All the world is blind to my passing.
No cop. Is there another floor or something? I miss these stairs sometimes. Hard to see. This is a representation of Torm, the god of loyalty and obedience. I'm gonna check the stables. There's a way out here as well. Oh, look at all those healing potions. Thank you. I'm surprised I wouldn't have picked that up before. See anything that looks like stairs. I feel like I'm missing something. So maybe... I think that goes outside, doesn't it? We're gonna have to run up to somebody and say, yo, give me that cup. Alright, let's see... We have... Oh, we should have kitted her out, right? Bolt plus two. We're out of extra healing for Minsk. Oh, here. That's from, what's her name? Stash. Nalia. She's not even with us right now. She had a lot of healing potions. Oh, those are... No, those are the healing potions I've been passing around. Never mind. She's got nothing. Yeah. Do we have something for her? I must have something in this bag for her. Gotta be something, man. Plate mail. Orc class 3. Orc leather. Orc class 4. Stone leather armor plus 1, 6, 3. If I remember right, I think she's not strong enough to carry the plate mail. But let me see. Inadequate strength, right. So, the best we can do is 6. This mail of the dead. Armor class 3. Flail of Ages. Oh, Lord Dionysus Flail. 33% chance of slowing target for 20 seconds. That's nice. I approve. Right, so she's got a weapon, armor. Well, there was a shield back there. Armor class -1. Oh, inadequate strength for the flail? Ah, 13 strength? Ugh, she has only 10 strength. You need to work out more, Viconia. Work out. That would have been sweet for you. But no! Only usable by shaman. Or shaman. Alright, never mind then. She's stuck with a quarterstaff plus 1, I'm afraid. And I guess a sling. Alright, give her some bullets. Believe it or not, I'm still just using regular bullets, so here, have that. Oh, I hate it's not gonna let me do it.
Yoshimo is willing.
There's some kind of shield over here. At least I think I saw one. Small shield. I return with the shield for Viconia. Class -2, pretty sweet. Unless we find her some kind of stronger armor that she can actually wear. Thinking of the Oncake plate mail. But that was another game. Yeah, we'll give that to her. I don't know. Well, let's go this way.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Maybe it's in that other area. The walled up area. Doesn't say, though. It does go outside. What's the trees? We can loot these trees.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
There's a gold thrown in there. Look at that. Scroll of identify. Do these trees have as well? These still glow up, I mean shine up. I had no idea we could loot trees. Or tree pots. What have you. Just those two, apparently. I have a few. I have 12 identify scrolls. Oh, we need to rest in order to get her spells going. Forgot about that. I don't think there's anywhere to rest here. No. Alright. Docks.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Oh, look. There's another area off from the docks. Huh. Look up, I don't know how we'd get over there. But anyway. So let's go here. Seas Bounty Tavern. Viconia with her spear. That spear, quarterstaff. Look like a spear. Who's that? Oh, people still mad at us from before? We have no wish to harm you.
The bigger they are, the harder I hit.
Nate, we need to visit the proprietor. There's someone else leaving. Alright.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
The thumb.
It's a cold and dreary day when the thumb can't extend a bit of hospitality to his guests. Come, enter and be welcome at the Sea's Bounty.
Why, thank you. Pretty sure I've read all that before. Noble accommodations. Alright.
Stand back for justice!
Alright, we return. I find this cup. Jahaboam? We talked to him before?
Have a look at my wares. I trust you'll find them all in satisfactory condition.
Take those. She can't use a large shield. She's 10 strength, Viconia. She can't even have a medium shield. So it's a small shield is what she has now. Seems to be identical to the buckler. Armor class plus 1 and no protection against missile attacks. Same. They both require 4 strength as well. Alright. Could use some of these. One more. Viconia doesn't really need that much. She's got the spells, so.
It is done.
It's a peasant. I found a peasant.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Where's the... Minsk!
See battle, Bo! Run, Bo, run!
Oh, run, Minsk, run. Got to include him back in the party. There you go.
You point, I punch.
And then he punches the entrance, or the exit, to the district.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
What's that? An empty niche or something. Yes, we are eventually going to go in the sewers underneath the city. But it's not even my priority right now. That seems like a long quest.
Gather your party before venturing forth.
Butt kicking for goodness!
All right. So we haven't really accomplished much. Just recruited Viconia and kitted her out a little bit. Looked around this place. Yeah, I'm not sure if they're in the right place or if it's next door to that area where they fight. They attack you as soon as you come in. Well, we'll find out next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.